Hello students, we have to continue with our part 3 of chapter number 1, economics, graph in economics. Here we have completed difference of a diagram and a graph and importance of a diagram and a graph. Now we have to continue with the types of diagram. Here different type of diagrams are there and it contains 2 marks or 3 marks in explanation in a board exam. So it is very important. Different type of diagrams you have to study now. Here first type is a line diagram. Here pictures which show the shape or a slope of the relationship between two variables are drawn. Two variables are drawn, that are two type of variables, independent variables and dependent variables. Independent variables are shown on the x-axis and dependent variables are shown on the y-axis. Be careful. 1 marks, it is very important which variables are on which axis. That is very important. X axis, dependent variable y axis. Okay, so that datas have given, some datas we have to put on a graph, that is on a line graph. Here the datas are given, it is in a decade. Decade means 10 years duration of time is given and growth rate of population in percentage is given. So here 1950 to 1961, here the percentage of growth rate is given of the population 21.64. Then 61 to 71, 71 to 81, that 10 years duration of time I have given the 24.80, 24.66, 23.87, that different ways have to be given. Here we have placed in a diagram that are of two axes. Here we have mentioned two axes. So vertical is of y-axis and horizontal is of x-axis. So here on a vertical we have to place dependent variable. Dependent means growth rate of the population. Be careful what data on which axis we have to place, that is very important. So here the dependent variables are, which are very important, and decades are on the x-axis. So here we have placed the duration of distance of 5, 5, 5, 10, 15, 16, like that, 15, 20, like that. And here years have to be given, 1951 to 61, 61 to 71, 71 to 81, like that. And we have placed this information of a population growth rate on the pictorial form. So here 21.64. So here we have to place 21, here 20 and little bit more, 64. So here we have placed the dot. Then after 24.80, 24 means less than 25. So 24.80, near about 25. Then 24.66, it is near by 24, so that have to be placed. And 23.87, so here we have placed 23.87. Then 21.54, 21 near about this 21, we have to see this line, and 21 we have to see over here, 21.54. okay, then afterwards 17.64, here it is near about 17. Here we can see that in a board exams you are having 5 marks of graph papers in 8 chapter. So that graph paper is of 10 duration of 1 inch of 10 is given. So that way it is easier for to make in a pictorial form. Now next is second bar diagram. There are of 3 types of bar diagrams: simple bar diagrams, cluster bar diagrams and dividend bar diagrams. So here we have to see only one, the type of diagram, simple bar diagram. And simple bar diagram, a variable or a horizontal bar, a vertical or a horizontal. Vertical, here we have seen that a vertical. Horizontal means horizontal are also be mentioned. Bars are drawn for each value of the variable. Here so many variables are there, that variables are changing, so that are given. And example is also given, rate of poverty in country of various time period. Rate of poverty in 1950, 1960, are given. So with the help of simple bar diagram, we can see this independent variables is shown on x axis. So here also that, and the dependent variables are shown on the y axis. Variables like time, place, etc. Here time is yours. It is mentioned the time. So that way, place means different state also we can mention on, different countries also we can mention. So that is the place. So that are the variables. Examples are there of variables. Here the datas are given, raw datas. From that data we have to place on the bar diagram. So here 1961 to 70, 71 to 80, 81 to 90, that growth rate is given 70.7.3, 3.7, 5.7, 7.7, 6%. Okay, so that way we have to place on a pictorial form and a bar diagram. Horizontal is of x-axis and vertical. Vertical means a standing line. Vertical is of y-axis. That is very careful. And on horizontal line we have to place the years, and on vertical growth rate in a percentage we have to mention. Whatever the data we have given, from that we have to identify the interval. Class interval we have to identify. Here so small number of data are given, so that way we have to mention the interval 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like that we have got the interval. And here the years, each year we have to place here. Then 1961 to 70, that is of 7.3. So here 7 where is the 7, 7.3 means little bit more. So we have to place the bar over here 61 to 70. Then 71 to 80, 3.7. 71 to 80, 3.7. 3.7 is 3, more than 3. It is of near about 4. So we have to place one bar. And be careful that each bar have to be in a same interval. And it is from the origin point. 0 is the origin. That is very important. The distance between each bar is also the same. That's why it is a perfection make. Then 81 to 90, third diagram, 81 to 90, that is of 5.7, little bit more than 5, and we have to place it on a bar here. Then 91 to 2000, here 7.7, more than 7, near about 8, that have to place the bar. And lastly 2001 to 10, 6, it is exact 6, we have to place the bar. So we can see that datas are given, informations are given, that numbers we have to place on the pictorial form, and it is self-explanatory and easier to understand. Okay, so that is the next session. We have to continue with this two of a clustered bar diagram and dividend bar diagram. Till that, next time.